Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Melanie and I make videos about living in Copenhagen. It's a very wet, chilly October morning here and I'm on my way into the main library in the centre of Copenhagen. Now, for many, many years they have had a fantastic children's section there. I used to take my son there often when he was a little boy, when he was like sort of a baby up until toddler age. And they had loads of resources that you could use there, the things that your children could play with, like dressing up clothes. They had a pirate ship. They had all sorts of things there. It was a brilliant place to go because it was free, it got you out of this dreadful weather in the winter, and it also encouraged children to have an interest in books. So we would often sit on the sofas in there and look at the books. But today we're meeting up with Sara, who is the project manager behind the brand new children's section, which is called Læs, which is the Danish word for read. So we're going to head inside, we're going to meet Sara, and we're going to take a look around this new section. Let's go.
Well, welcome to Copenhagen Main Library, the children's floor. My name is Sara Nygård, and I'm the project manager of the children's floor. We have 1,000 square meters of children's library, which is brand new, and where the main focus is to get children to read more books, but also to get parents and the adults to understand why it's important to read books. We have 10 zones at the children's floor, which each zone is made for a specific group of children. So we have, for example, a zone for the smaller kids and then all the way up from 0 to 12 years. The 10 zones are is a landscape of nature and of cityscape. Where we hope that children and parents can explore and find books and be tactile and motivated to find good reading experiences. During Corona, we can't have as many activities as we were hoping for when we opened, but we are looking forward to a time where we can see Baby Book Club in our sound meadow, or have suitcase stories in our word mountain, and also drawing sessions and writing sessions for both smaller and bigger kids. We opened in August and have been open since, and our experience is that both children and parents are really enjoying the floor and taking it in. When we opened, it was a soft launch, so it was first until start of October. We kind of advertised that now the floor is open, and since the official opening, we've seen about 300 visitors per day, of course, spread out all through the day from morning till evening. And we also, of course, take our precautions to Corona. So you can always go to our webpage and check how many is on the floor now. Is it safe to come or should I stay home? So we're kind of monitoring the flow of visitors for everyone's safety. So when we open up for our activities once again, one of the things you will experience on our children's library will be suitcase stories, which is where one of our hosts, one of our children librarians, will open a suitcase full of stories. I found one here with Little Red Riding Hood, where they will read the book aloud to the children, but they will also invite the children to reenact the story. So we have all kinds of props, a wolf, a red cloak, I think it's called.
Yeah.
That they can reenact the story and have a nice time around literature. So now I'm standing in our section of foreign children's books. So that means children's books in languages as English, French, Spanish, Deutsch, but also a smaller section of other varieties of languages. This is a showcase where we hope you can find inspiration, but do know that we have a web page and an app where you can search and find much more than the ISCs in this section, but a great place to find inspiration for foreign children's books. Perfect. So now I'm in the other end of the floor, which is for the bigger kids. The floor is made in a way where you start in the smaller section and you move kind of clockwork around the floor as your child or the child gets bigger. So now we are in all of the literature and the novels and the non-fiction for the bigger kids, school kids especially. Good. So one of the main thoughts of this floor is also that it's an analog floor, that at this floor we kind of suggest to the parents to maybe put their phones away and be together with your kids around literature, around a good book, around a good conversation. So that is one of our main ideas around this floor. Lots of literature, lots of activities around literature, but also a place where you put away your phone and you have an experience together around literature and books. So one of the things we see at the new floor is that maybe there's more for everyone. Now you can still find a good book as you could at the old children's library. But maybe for parents or kids who rather want to read at home, there's other activities to engage in. You can find letters, maybe the first letter of your name. You can write small words. You can make towers of letters. So maybe the combination of a lot of books, but also activities around language and books, makes more possibilities for more people at the floor. The new children's library is a space where you find a lot of books, a lot of literature, but it's also designed with a lot of knowledge of brain science, of language, and a lot of knowledge around language and how you have a good start with what we call early literacy. So here you will meet a lot of letters. You will find inspiration as a parent to talk about letters, to sense, feel letters in the space. So it's a room where you also find support as parent, or maybe also as daycare or anyone else to start early with the language acquisition. So on our new children's library, we have a few more rules than earlier, but hopefully rules that will make an even better visit for you and your family or the children you're with. It's a no shoes floor. That means that you wear socks or you put on these blue loafers on your shoes. It's also we also have a dining area where you're very welcome to eat your lunch pack. And of course, if you're breastfeeding, you're very welcome to breastfeed all over the floor. Breastfeeding is very okay. We also have changing facilities if you need to change diapers, and of course lots of bathrooms to both kids and adults. Thank you for visiting and hope to see you soon.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Because of Corona times, I'm having to wear a mask now because the library is open. But I think this new children's section is a fabulous addition to this amazing library. And it's a great addition to the city. It's free to come in. There are so many resources here for you to enjoy with your friends and your family and your children. So whichever part of the library that you're going to. But I just want to show you behind me what it looks like. Now, I was going to do a bit of a guessing game and say, can you guess what this building used to be? But I think I'll just tell you. It used to be a department store, a lot like Ilan Bollihus is. Just up on Stroll, you've got this central atrium and everything around it. So you can imagine each of these floors would have been a different department in a department store. But for many, many decades, this has been the central and main library in Copenhagen. And I love it. And I urge you to come and visit this library, whether you have kids and you want to come to this new lace section, or you want to enjoy the rest of the library. There is so much to do, and the resources here are fabulous. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Until next time, bye for now.